বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়
নিশ্চয়ই যে আল্লাহর সাথে শিরকে লিপ্ত হয় আল্লাহ তার জন্য জান্নাতকে হারাম করে দেন এবং জাহান্নাম অবধারিত করে দেন।
শহীদুল্লাহ খান মাদানী।
জান্নাতে যাওয়ার এবং জাহান্নাম হতে বাঁচার একটি মাত্র পথ, তাওহীদ। আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলার তাওহীদ জানার জন্য দেখুন আমার ধারাবাহিক দার্স কিতাবুত তাওহীদ।
দেখুন কিতাবুত তাওহীদ কাল রাত 11টায় বা পুনঃ সম্প্রচার সকাল 10টায় বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়। For humanity.
Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad Rasulullah.
Sometimes I wake and
we, students of Islamic International School, welcome you to the annual day event.
I am the most powerful creature on the earth.
Bana chahta hu Allah ke shaitan aur dooch.
Please go away.
Go forward, young Muslims, wherever you are. In the shadow of the sun or by your light of a star.
Inna Allah ta'ala.
To aap abhi bhi doctor hai.
Muslims, wherever you are.
أيها المستمعون الكرام, As-Salaam Alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ana Alia Faruqi, al-taliba fi saf al-rabi' al-ibtidai. Ukaddimu bayna aydikum al-hadith al-nabawi ma'a al-tarjama. An Jabir radiyallahu anhu qala, Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yakul, Inna bayna wajli wa bayna al-shirki wal-kufri tarka salah. Rawahu Muslim. Narrated Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu anhu. Jabir heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Verily between man and between polytheism and unbelief is the negligence of prayer. Sahih Muslim, volume number 1, hadith number 147.
Ayyuhal Afil Kareem, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. معكم أنا سلمان شيخ الطالب في المستوى الخامس. ألقي عليكم أذكار الصباح والمساء مع الترجمة. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق. ألم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على أهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسوله. اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. I seek refuge in the perfect words of Allah from the evil which He has created. O Allah, You are my Lord. There is none worthy of worship except You. You created me, and I am Your slave. I keep Your covenant and my pledge to You as far as I am able, and I accept my misdeeds, so forgive me. There is no one who forgives sins except You. O Allah, I have entered a new morning, and I call upon You and upon the bearers of Your throne, Your angels and all Your creation, to bear witness that You are Allah. There is none worthy of worship except You, and Muhammad is Your slave and messenger. O Allah, I ask You for beneficial knowledge, good provisions, and acceptable deeds.
أيها الحفل الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. معكم أنا عائشة زارو، الطالبة في المستوى الخامس. ألقي عليكم حديثا من أحاديث الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم مع الترجمة. عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يتمنى أن أحدكم الموت لزر أصابه، فإن كان لابد فاعلا فليقل: اللهم أهني ما كانت الحياة خيرا لي وتوفني إذا كانت الوفاة خيرا لي. متفق عليه. Narrated Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu. The Prophet peace be upon him said, none of you should wish for death because of a calamity befalling him. But if he has to wish for death, he should say, O Allah, keep me alive as long as life is better for me, and let me die if death is better for me. Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 7, hadith number 5671.
A masjid is a place of sujood. Any other act is considered rude. Many of these myths let us get rid. 7th and 8th standard in the role of the masjid.
As-Salaam-Alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Wa alaikum as-salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Welcome, Brother Adil. It's so nice of you to travel all the way from Medina to be a part of our masjid.
Jazakallah. It is my duty, brother. I'm very sorry to hear that the old Imam Tawfiq has taken ill. But I hope that you will help me since you have been with this masjid for many years. I am new to this part of the world, but I'm sure your experience will benefit me, inshallah.
Of course. As you see, I have spent 16 years in this masjid and I plan to be here for the rest of my life. I have been living here, taking care of it as well as giving the adhan. This is home to me.
I see. You are taking good care of the masjid, keeping it clean, neat and tidy.
Of course. I take very good care of it. I love this place. Okay, Imam. Please make yourself comfortable in the quarters while I go about my duties.
By all means, carry on. I shall just be here for some time.
Okay.
I just have one question. May I ask?
Why not? Please go ahead.
This masjid has a very good location. There are quite a lot of houses around here. About 100 or so. But there are only 20 odd people in the masjid, even though today is a holiday.
The people over here are not very religious. They are not interested in coming to the masjid. Shall I do my work?
Yeah, sure.
Please, people, do not gather around here. Go home. Salah time is over and there's a lot of time for Zohar Salah. The masjid will open 15 minutes before the adhan. The timings are done outside. Please, please,
brothers. Please not leave. Brother Abdullah, why are you driving these people away?
See, ma'am, if they shall stay, they shall make the masjid dirty. They shall sit and gossip and make it noisy. After all, it is a place of worship. It should be treated with respect.
But along with Salah, the masjid can be used for various halal leisure activities. Do you remember the hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume 1, hadith number 455, wherein the Prophet, peace be upon him, had allowed some Ethiopians to play with spears in the masjid?
But there is nikah at 11 a.m.
Alhamdulillah, that is very nice. I think today is going to be a busy day. I have invited some guests at 4 p.m.
See, ma'am, you are new to this place. We only have Salah and nikah over here.
The masjid can be used for various leisure activities. Salah and nikah are only a few of them. Brothers, you may stay here if you wish. As today is a holiday, I'm sure you may want to talk to some of your friends. You may sit in one corner. And if you have any questions or problems, please feel free to discuss with me.
And what are you doing over here? Did I not tell you to go home?
But we want to just sit here and read.
Go home and read. Your mother is waiting for you. Now leave at once.
But my father is sitting there. The Imam has allowed him to stay back.
That's only for others, not for children.
Why? Please let us stay, Uncle Abdullah. Please.
You all are nothing but only mischief makers.
But we are not making noise. Please, please let us stay.
Please let us stay, Mom.
Okay, you can surely stay. But see that you don't make a lot of noise.
But they will make noise. I know. I have known them since years. Just see, they'll just start running around.
In fact, it's a good thing that they prefer to stay in the masjid rather than go in any other place with any other company.
But they will start running around and disturbing others.
That's not good, disturbing others. Look, I have an idea. There is a little place outside the masjid. Why don't we make a small garden for them so that they can run about and come out and play while their parents are discussing something?
Yeah!
I don't think that's a good idea.
Let us at least try, brother.
See, ma'am, do as you please. I'm here to serve. I shall do whatever you want. But the last imam had really good and strict rules.
I'm sure he must have been good. But come, let us make things ready for the nikah.
How? With all these people? I shall close the doors and then do all the preparations.
Don't you worry, brother. We shall take the help of these people. Please, brothers, there is a nikah ceremony going to take place here. Can you help us clean the masjid?
Sure, we would be glad to help.
Jazakallah. All I
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك لا شريك لك
لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك
إن الحمد
والنعمة
لك والملك
لا شريك لك
الله أكبر الله أكبر
আল্লাহর কালাম কোরআন বুঝতে চান? কোরআন বুঝতে হলে সহায়ক হিসাবে কোরআন সংশ্লিষ্ট কিছু বিষয় জানতে হবে। এই বিষয়গুলো আলোচিত হয়েছে উলুমুল কোরআন শিরোনামে। উলুমুল কোরআন সিরিজ শুনতে ও দেখতে আমার উপস্থাপিত প্রোগ্রাম চোখ রাখুন একমাত্র পিস টিভি বাংলায়।
কোরআন কে ভালোভাবে বুঝবার জন্য কি বিষয়ে জ্ঞান রাখা জরুরি জানতে হলে দেখুন উলমুল কোরআন ও ইসলামী আদর্শ প্রতি রবিবার রাত 8:30 বা পুনঃ সম্প্রচার সকাল 7:00 বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়। ম্যারেজ ও ডিভোর্স,
ইসলামিক রুলিং,
নিকাহ,
সলিউশন ও প্রবলেম, হেভেন ও হেল,
দ্যাট ইজ এ মিসকনসেপশন,
ইউ চুজ beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik. দেখুন অর্ধাঙ্গিনী নাতিত্বাঙ্গিনী প্রতি রবিবার রাত 7:30টায় আপন সম্প্রচার সকাল 9:30টায় বাংলাদেশে পিএস টিভি বাংলায়।
Come let us make things ready for the nikah.
How? With all these people, I shall close the doors and then do all the preparations.
Don't you worry, brother. We shall take the help of these people. Please, brothers, there is a nikah ceremony going to take place here. Can you help us clean the masjid?
Sure, we would be glad to help.
Jazakallah.
Look at him.
He doesn't want to help. By the way, who is he?
I don't know.
He stays in Fifth Brick Avenue with his family. His name is Bilal.
How come you do not know him? A masjid is a place where people from the locality come together and know each other. One Muslim can befriend another Muslim. After Salah, one should inquire about each other's well-being.
That's true.
Now, you look at him. He seems disturbed. I wonder what his problem is. Come, let me go and speak to him. As-Salaam-Alaikum, Brother Bilal. I am Imam Adil, the new Imam of this masjid. How are you, brother?
Fine. Alhamdulillah. Did I do something wrong? Do I need to go? I will, if you'll tell me.
No, brother. You may stay here as long as you wish. But tell me, why are you so sad? What is troubling you? Can my brothers and I be of any assistance to you?
I don't know what to say. My wife is very sick. She needs to go for an operation on an emergency basis, but I have not been able to gather enough money. I sold my assets and a gold too, but I have not been able to gather enough money. I don't know what to do.
Did you ask your friends?
No, I have no heart to ask any of them, and I don't know if they would want to help me.
I shall see. What can I do? Please wait. Brother Bilal, you are so lucky. Allah is really very kind. Brother Kaleem is a surgeon and he will refer some of his doctor friends who will inshallah give you a discount.
I am so in debt to you and Brother Kaleem.
See, had you known him, you would have avoided all this tension.
Oh, people have started coming for the nikah. And here's the groom. What do you want? Salah time is at Zohar. We are very busy today. The new Imam has invited a few special guests from UK.
Actually, I was looking for someone who's in charge of the mosque.
Tell me, I'll take care of it. But first let me introduce you to the new Imam, Brother Adil from Medina.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam. Brother, I have a young eligible daughter of marriageable age. I'm looking for a nice Muslim pious boy for her. Can you recommend someone who's a regular at the masjid?
Do you have somebody in mind?
No. Since I'm not regular at the masjid, I don't even know anybody. Since you're the Imam, you must know so many people. You must know of their characteristics and personalities too. Maybe you can introduce me to them?
What? This is a masjid, not some marriage bureau. Let us get on with the real role of a masjid.
Brother, we shall speak later. Please, brother, tell me your difficulty. Okay, give me your telephone number. As I'm new here, I do not even know anyone yet. I shall get back to you as soon as I have something for you. May Allah ease your task for you and may your daughter get a good pious marriage partner.
Ameen.
It's good that you're concerned about your daughter, but aren't you concerned about your akhirah? Brother, you should be regular with your prayer. And remember, a parent's dua is most beneficial to the child.
Inshallah.
So we have also started matchmaking in the mosque. Out, you dirty, filthy people. Get out of here. You're dirty and dripping with blood. Out.
Help us, save us. People are trying to harm us. They have to run out of our home.
Nothing doing. Get out of here. And why are you driven out of your houses? You must be criminals.
Oh no, there are communal lights going in our area. Please save us, help us.
Nothing doing, get out of here. You're making the masjid impure with your blood, sweat and mud. This is a masjid.
This is a place of worship. A place where one can help each other's fellow human. Come. You're bleeding so badly. You need to be treated to go to the hospital.
Yes. Send them to the hospital.
Asad, come here fast. Get some first aid. Asad, run to the doctor to get some first aid. And also get the youth of the area so that they can treat the wounded. Come quick.
What? First aid? This is not a hospital. Huh? First aid.
And Abdullah, get out the bed sheet. We need to stop the blood flow.
Imagine Imam and Muazzin doing all this. Never has this masjid become so dirty and filthy. A place of salah. And see what has this become.
Please do not waste time. And do as I say. And quick. Send the sisters to the lady doctor. Come on. You get some clean water. Ah, Alhamdulillah, that was great. Doctor, you too were a great help. And you boys, you too were excellent.
Is it all okay? Can we go? We are playing.
Oh really? What?
Football.
It's nice. Which club?
We do not have a club, so no one sponsors us.
Look, I have an idea. If you come regularly to the mosque for one whole month, 5 times for Salah, then I can request someone to help you all.
Really? Can we come? But we do not know much about Islam, so we do not come.
No problem. After Salah, I shall spend time in order to teach you. And after that, we can discuss football moves too.
That's all that was left. Now, the mosque has also become a clubhouse. Brother, you don't know these youths. They shall sit here and talk all sorts of nonsense.
Inshallah, they won't. We shall supervise them.
What shall we name our football club?
Peace Mosque Football Club. Allah.
Can I sometimes come in and study? I have an MBA exam coming up. And my house is too small.
What? I'm not going to keep the mosque open for you all night. This is a mosque, not some study room library.
A masjid can be a masjid as well as a place for gaining knowledge. Gaining knowledge is a part of ibadah. Come boys, help me up tidy the room. I've invited some guests at 4 p.m.
Stop! You cannot come in. Only Muslims are allowed.
Hey, what's the matter now? I just want to see the place. What do Muslims do? And Hindu worship.
Come out. We shall sit on the steps and talk.
What nonsense? Don't wait. I'm not interested in sitting here. Help us.
Please, brother, please do not leave. I'm sorry. Please come in. It would just be nice if you could remove your footwear.
Can I really come in?
No, you cannot. Yeah, wear this so that it covers you appropriately.
Now what?
You are not covered appropriately. Look at your head. It's not covered.
This is too much.
Brother, you can come in as you are. You are our guest. We honor and respect you.
Disrespect. I shall not tolerate this anymore. No respect for Islam or the mosque.
The Prophet had a discussion with the Christian deputation from Najran for 3 days in the masjid. Brother, please do not be rude. We shall speak later.
Wow, that's nice. You do all this in your mosque. Is this in your religion or you are inventing something of your own?
According to Sahih Bukhari, Volume 1, Book of Salah, we come to know that a masjid can be used for a place of relaxation, refuge for the travelers and seeking the pleasure of Allah. It can also be used for celebration, socializing, worship and prayer. Subhanallah, these are the actual roles of a masjid.
Imam, you have opened my eyes. Since years I have been in this masjid, but I never knew the real role of the masjid. Alhamdulillah, you have revived the lost sunnah of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Earlier, it was difficult to manage the mosque all alone, but now I have helping hands. It's indeed a pleasure to have a masjid like a community center. I welcome you, Imam Adil.
Time to go to the masjid. Wash your face up and pick the pace up. It's time to go to the masjid. Help your mother to get your brother. It's time to go to the masjid. It's a wonderful place to go as a family. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there. So upsie daisy, now don't be lazy. It's time to go to the masjid. We'll greet everyone with salam when we're at the masjid. Listen carefully to the imam when we're at the masjid. It's a wonderful place to go, made for you and me. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there. So upsie daisy, now don't be lazy. It's time to go to the masjid. First we'll sit and read Quran when we're at the masjid. Next we pray with everyone when we're at the masjid. It's a wonderful place to go, a wonderful place to be. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there. We'll be standing all together in prayer. We'll meet all our friends when we are there.
কেন ইসলাম দিয়েছে ভালো আচরণের উপর এত জোর, বোঝার জন্য দেখুন চরিত্র।